Whispers Instructional ASMR. Today I'm doing another mosaic. It's another bit of fan art, like I mentioned in my last videos with the feather. That was fan art as well. This one is quite apparent. Should recognize Corvus. See, this is the leather mask, which aesthetically I prefer. However, my favorite video with him is, I think it's called The Beak. Ever so gently. And with the beak, I'm pretty sure he was wearing the other mask with the hard tip on it. But in that video, me ASMR that starts at the front of the forehead and works its way. Actually, this is a bigger one. I might use it somewhere back here. Okay. Grabbing this a darker color so that way these little details, like these little rounds, will show up as rounds, and so I'll just leave a little grout line around them. That way the dark ground will accentuate the shape of the little round. So like the other one, ephemeral rift. If you are watching this and you want this mosaic, just let me know, and we can get it sent out once I get it done. Oh yeah, fair warning. Taking sips of a drink here throughout this video. So if you don't like drinking sounds, I'm sorry. But there's probably not going to be a time in this video where not going to be a risk of me taking a drink at any moment. So So yeah, I'd just like to say thank you to all the content creators who've been so kind and reached out, especially Ephemeral Rift. Made some good comments, sent me a couple messages, and really made me feel welcome. Shared my Bubble Boy Brigade video. Really appreciate that. Really appreciate him kind of giving me the nod. Go ahead and make that. He read my comment on his podcast. If you have not checked out Ephemeral Rift's podcast, definitely do that. There's a couple that really resonated. Episode 1 podcast about taking risks. Huge inspiration when I started this channel 3 months ago, 4 months ago, something like that. Felt like a risk to start my channel. It was a worrisome ordeal for me. I had nothing to worry about. Everyone's been really, really kind and supportive, so. Really, that podcast inspired me to start the Free Dreamers role plays and start the storyline that I have, I'm trying to build there. Another one. I think it's his podcast, his third one. He talks about purpose. That's another good one I really enjoyed. You read a lot of viewer comments, and when it comes to a subject like that, looking at different perspectives, keeping an open mind, is admirable, and I feel like that's what he was trying to do in that podcast. So I think that format was perfect for that subject. About anger management, which just so happened to come at a time when I was pretty upset about a few things. Really as uniform in size as I guess I would like them to be, but that's kind of the joy of Mosaic. I don't know, kind of the, I guess not joy, but try the charm. Experiences in another podcast with leaving religion. That he grew up in. I grew up in Utah, Mormon, and no longer religious at all. However, my experience for leaving was quite a bit different, although that's a story for another time. Because it wasn't just, there was a different dynamic to it. But if you're listening to this, ER, thank you for sharing that. Hearing other people's experiences, even if, I mean, I like listening to religious people talk about their religious experiences and finding God. That interests me too. But I also like to hear stories about people opening their minds, which sounds pretentious. I'm not trying to say that religious people have closed minds. Anyway, I'm not going to go too much into this. I suggest everyone listen to his stories. And then, of course, the about extending a hand to some newer ASM artists, me included. Thank you very much for that, for extending a welcoming hand and helping me out. Really appreciate that. So, and then he talks about E3 and stuff, some different things. And then he did the gay marriage one podcast. So here in the United States, because I know some people who are listening may not be from the United States, but yeah, we if you haven't heard, of course you've heard, they legalized gay marriage here in the United States through a Supreme Court. Had a podcast that may have upset a few people. that he expressed there. I don't want to upset anyone. But when you have people in your life who you love, who've been there for you your entire life, and they love someone and they want to marry them, to know that they're now able to do that symbol of love. And to be fair, I'm someone who not a big fan of marriage, like, for myself. If other people want to do it, right on. But as of right now in my life, that's not a commitment that I foresee myself making. But to know that someone who was previously prevented from being married is now able to be married, and is something that I celebrate. I'm really happy that they can do that, share their symbol of love, and not just them, everyone who are in similar situations. So again, ephemeral rift, if you're watching, since this is an homage to your channel, that's why I'm talking so much about you. But again, thank you for making that episode. With all that being said, I highly suggest his channel. Alright, and we've got all those in. Okay, now. Now to channel news. I have been introducing characters and trying to introduce a few names of places to start building out my Free Dreamer storyline. Although I plan on having one or two more character introduction videos that'll be similar to the ones that I've done in the Free Dreamers. And then we'll probably move on to a portion where I might be able to start building a little more of a coherent storyline. That way Because when I'm trying to create like a whole new like universe kind of a thing. So a little bit of introduction for the setting, I think, might be kind of nice. Whoops. Shit. That way it might be a little easier for people to follow the story I'm trying to build. Although, because I don't know how coherent my vision is. I feel like there's a lot of information that about what I'm talking about that can be expressed. Again, still in the storytelling aspect, but maybe almost like a reference, like beginner's guide to the dreamscape kind of a thing. That way, although more of a storytelling thing, that way people can understand the universe that I'm trying to create. Characters that I'm trying to build will start interacting with each other here and the story will start progressing. Still semi in the character development stage. So I've got one more of those, and then one or two more character videos, and then an explanation story kind of video, and then I guess, yeah, that's the plan for that storyline. I've got another heartbeat video planned. Pretty excited about. to be in a role play style. And then I've got, as far as the basic binaural videos, I'm planning on doing a layered video, and then an ear-to-ear, another ear-to-ear, like whisper video, and a layered video, ear-to-ear whisper video. Ear-to-ear whisper and tapping. Kind of like my show and tell that I've done in the past. And then I've got mouth sounds / unintelligible whisper video planned. I need to finish my Alice in Wonderland because I still have Through the Looking Glass to finish. And then, let's see, I am going to get Robin Hood done. I started that so long ago. Every time I've gone hiking, I haven't gone by myself yet, and it's hard to find people I've been hiking with are really interested in stopping by and somewhere in the woods and listening to me read. I don't know why. It sounds awesome to me, but I guess they're more interested in hiking rather than sitting around reading or being read to. Some solo backpacking, I think, and that should give me enough opportunities to stop a few different places and get some serious reading done for you. Because I really enjoy Robin Hood. So, that's what I'm going to do, is I'm just going to keep building out and flow it back. So I guess that's channel news. Oh yeah, and I'm really planning on getting another guided visualization in. Those are the hardest for me because I can't just like sit down and do them. I can't just like get in character and do them. I have to like actually write them out. Read them out, and to actually sit down and write it out, and everything, is something really hard for me. I've gotten lots of new subscribers. Thank you all so much. Thank you, everyone. Sorry if it sometimes seems like I say I'll do your suggestion and then it takes me a long time to get it done. But some things are harder for me to do than others. Obviously some of that is partly what I have a passion for, and then so, what I have time and ability to actually do. So far, the channel has been lots of fun for me, and very good motivation. Sorry if you hear the background noise. Someone must have turned something on in the house. There we go. It's off now. So maybe I'll just do a little bit of humming. Glue on my finger. Thank you. Mm-hmm.